हेलो एवरीवन, डे विद क्लियर सनराइज मेक्स अस हैप्पी। व्हेन इट इज टू हॉट वी आर हैप्पियर टू सी द क्लाउड्स एंड मे हैव रेन। आवर एक्टिविटी इज इमेंसली इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द कंडीशन ऑफ वेदर और हाउ इट गोज थ्रू आउट द डे। वेदर इट इज हॉट और कोल्ड, वेट और ड्राई, काम और स्टॉर्मी, क्लियर और क्लाउडी। Weather is so important that they are daily forecast on television, radio and newspapers. Climate, on the other hand, is the averaging of such atmospheric condition over longer periods of time. Let's take a look about weather and climate. The conditions of temperature, humidity, atmospheric pressure and wind, cloud cover and precipitation in a particular place at a particular time is called weather. The weather keeps changing from day to day and can even change within few hours. Variation of weather can be recorded daily, monthly or annually, which lead to the concept of climate. The climate of a region is the average weather condition over a span of 30 to 40 years. The climate remains almost the same for years together. There are seven major climatic regions in the world. For example, India has tropical monsoon type of climate. There are basic difference between weather and climate. The state of different atmospheric elements in a particular place and time is known as weather. The average state of weather of a region for a period of 35 to 40 years is known as climate. Weather changes within a specific day or even hours. But climate does not change every day. Weather differences may be found within a small area. Climate changes across a vast region. Major elements of weather and climate are air temperature, humidity, air pressure and wind, cloudiness and rainfall. Air temperature, insolation. The temperature of the outer surface of Sun is 6000 degrees centigrade. The energy which is emitted from the Sun is coming towards the Earth and is known as incoming solar radiation or insolation. Insolation is considered as 100%. It can be classified into two: effective solar radiation 66% and albedo 34%. Among the insolation or 100%, 34% is reflected or refracted back to the space, which is known as albedo. Among 34%, 6% is space scattering, 25% reflected by the cloud and 3% reflected by the Earth's surface. Remaining 66% is absorbed by the surface and atmosphere, which is responsible to warming up of the atmosphere. It is known as effective solar radiation. Among 66%, 18% is absorbed by atmosphere and cloud. 48% is absorbed by Earth's surface, which is almost entirely reflected back at night. That is known as terrestrial radiation. The Earth's axis is tilted at an angle of 66.5 degree to its orbital plane. In summer, the sun rays fall vertically on the Earth's surface, so the temperature is high. In winter, the sun rays fall obliquely on the Earth's surface, so the temperature drops. The angle at which sunlight strikes on the Earth's surface is called angle of incidence of sunlight on the Earth. Vertical sun rays incident within a small area of the Earth's surface and makes the region warm. Oblique sun rays incident over a vast area of the Earth's surface and cause low temperature on that region. Low latitudinal region has vertical sun rays. At and near the equator, sunlight hits Earth directly, delivering more heat and light at any given spot. High latitudinal region has oblique sun rays. Toward the poles, the sun rays hit Earth at an oblique angle and are spread over a larger area, diffusing their energy. The Earth's surface is heated up by energy from the sun. As one moves higher up, the colder it gets. Temperature falls at the rate of 6.5 degrees centigrade per 1000 meter or 1 kilometer. It is known as normal lapse rate. There are three major processes of warming up of the atmosphere. Radiation. The energy from the sun directly heats up the Earth's surface. This heat is then radiated to the lower layer of atmosphere. This process is called radiation. Conduction. As the lower layer of atmosphere is warmed up by radiation, the heat is transmitted to the next upper layers of atmosphere. This process is called conduction. Convection. The lowest layer of air closest to the Earth's surface gets heated first. The warm air gets lighter and moves upwards. The cool air of upper atmosphere gradually settles down. This cold air then gets heated and in turn moves upwards. The Earth's atmosphere gets heated in this way. This is known as method of convection. In convection, air masses are circulated from lower to upper part of atmosphere, and it is known as convection current. The inner part of convection current is known as convective heat cell. Heat zones. Temperature decreases gradually from equator to the poles. This is because of the difference of the angle of incidence of sunlight. The Earth has been divided into three heat belts on the basis of the amount of heat it receives from the sun, like torrid zone, temperate zone, and frigid zone. Torrid zone, the region on either side of equator lying between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn is known as torrid zone. Sunlight falls vertically throughout the year in this belt, and the Earth's surface gets most heated up here. Temperate zone. The belts between Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle and that between Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle are known as temperate zone. Sunlights are oblique in nature here. So, it is cooler than the torrid zone. Frigid zone. The region from Arctic Circle to North Pole and from Antarctic Circle to South Pole are known as frigid zone. Sunlight falls at a very high oblique angle here throughout the year. So, it is least heated belt of the Earth. It remains cold throughout the year. The instrument to measure temperature of a region is called thermometer. The maximum and minimum temperature of a day can be measured by 6S thermometer after the name of James 6. It is also used to measure average temperature and range of temperature. Humidity. The amount of water vapor present in a specific volume of air mass having a definite temperature is known as humidity of air mass. Generally, it is measured in percentage. Humidity of an air can be measured by hygrometer. It is of two types, like analog hygrometer and digital hygrometer. Air pressure and wind. The amount of pressure exerted by molecules of definite volume of gas on a specific area of the Earth's surface is known as air pressure. Air pressure can be classified into two, like high pressure and low pressure. The instrument for measuring atmospheric pressure is called barometer or 14th barometer. In order to maintain the equilibrium of pressure, air blows from area of high pressure to area of low pressure. If the air pressure falls suddenly at a place, air from adjacent areas of high pressure rushes at a great speed to the low pressure area. This can cause a storm. Wind moving at a great speed can uproot trees and make houses collapse in its path. Warnings are sounded for fishermen not to go out to the river or the sea to catch fishes, as there is warning. Sometimes gentle wind movement are observed as the air pressure decreases gradually in a region. The direction of wind is recorded by an instrument called wind vane or weather cock. Wind speed is measured by an instrument like anemometer. Units are used in anemometer are kilometer per hour or nautical mile or knot per hour. Cloudiness. The measurable portion of cloud in the sky is called cloud cover or cloudiness. It can be measured by unit octa. The octa can be expressed by percentage. 0% cloud cover suggests clear sky. 25% cloud cover represent partly cloudy sky. 75% cloud cover suggest almost overcast, and 100% cloud cover represent full overcast. Rainfall. The water vapor transform into water droplets by releasing latent heat and form cloud. These droplets join together to form large water particle and fall on the Earth's surface by the influence of gravity. This is called rainfall. As moisture-laden air is light, it moves upwards. Since the temperature and pressure of air above is less, moisture cools down and turns into little droplets of water. This process is called condensation. These water particles gather around the dust particles floating in air to form clouds. These particles merge together and fall down to the surface by gravity as they become heavier. Hence, the rainfall is occurred. Rainfall is measured by an instrument known as rain gauge. Weather forecast. Daily weather reports are forecasted in radio, television, and newspapers. The meteorological or weather office collects facts and prepares weather maps for every 24 hours. This information is passed on to the newspaper and broadcasting stations. The weather office forecasts the weather of a place generally for the coming 24 hours or 48 hours. This is called weather forecast. strong winds at a speed of 80 km per hour are going to blow over Sundarbans. Fishermen are advised not to venture out into the sea. These forecasts are often heard or read in the media. The headquarters of the Meteorological Department of West Bengal is at Alipur, and the headquarters of Indian Meteorological Department is Mausam Bhavan, Delhi. Thank you.